Stefan, what is wrong? Where is Sam Adams?
Who cares? I've been robbed!
Vont me le payer, ces scélérats de merde!
Where are you going?
To get back what's rightfully mine.
Some pathetic red, I will match your face to your jacket, Scapule!
Ces coquins me prennent mon père au Canada, et voilà qu'ils me ravissent ma propriété ici. Il suffit. English! We are not the King's men! We are free! But the King sends these red coats to push us around! They are not our masters! This is our city! Let's show them who owns it! It's time to fight!
Stefan, please! Stop and listen to me!
I've listened for long enough! They come into my home and take my things? I will get my revenge! The man responsible for this will pay! His friends will pay. Voilà trop longtemps que je subis ces affronts. Ils vont goûter de mon courroux. You looking for a fight, Englishman? I...
Ma maison, ils m'obligent à fuir mon pays, et les voici qui veulent s'approprier ma nouvelle demeure.
There is a way to fight injustice, but this is not it.
The world is descending into madness.
Destroyed? You stupid mongrel! I suppose you want me to tell Johnson his tea just spontaneously combusted? Nonsense! Someone's responsible for this, and you will find out who. And if you can't, I'll gut you and find a smarter mongrel who can.
What do we do? Create a window.
Bloody hell are you?
Why?
You have no right to rob people blind.
by decree of the British Parliament or not.
British Parliament? I work for William Johnson.
Johnson? End his suffering cleanly.
Please.
The people seem to have an ear for you. What are the things you lost?
The people listened to me only because I spoke the truth loud enough, which is worth 1,000 times the content of my footlocker. The English, they can keep my things.
You did well tonight.
I said I'd buy you an ale when you first helped me. In place of drink, I offer you my allegiance, for what it's worth.
Your aid is welcome, and I am grateful. Now, I need to find Sam Adams. What happens now?
We wait for the signal.
What signal?
This meeting can do nothing further to save the country.
That one.
Evening, gentlemen. Shall we be off?
No.
What's the matter?
I have spent today drawn from one bit of madness to another with nothing to show for it. Before I go any further, I would like to know exactly what it is you intend.
Of course. First, we make our way to Nathaniel Bradley's house to fetch the rest of our little group. Then it's on to Griffin's Wharf, where we board the ships and dump the tea. Simple as that.
Simple seems a bit charitable.
Cheer up, Connor. For tonight, we are all victors. The Sons of Liberty get to send a message to England, and you rob William Johnson of his financing. Your village will be saved.
I've an idea. Why don't you lead the way? That should keep us out of any further trouble. Am I right?
Damn it, more guards.
We need to turn the crowd's anger to our advantage.
Say the word, Connor, and I will make it so. We need to keep those bastards at bay while the tea's being dumped.
Let me up. I'm yours to command.
Oh, Save the last one for you. We get out of here. It is done.
Johnson is dead?
No. He retreated when we destroyed the tea.
Only to hatch some new scheme, I'm sure. You should have killed him.
There was no need.
Time will tell if you speak the truth.
Radun Hagedum! Radun Hagedum!
Ganondokon, why are you here? Has something happened?
William Johnson has returned with all the money required to buy our land. He meets with the elders as we speak. I have begged him to resist, but I fear he shall have his way unless you intervene.
How is this possible? We destroyed the tea.
The Templars are nothing if not resourceful. You should have heeded my warning.
Please, you have to stop him.
Of course. Can you tell me where they are meeting?
Izzy not gonna daradit canusude ne Johnson's yunja der roxta. Guahigansi what neganun haradum hagedum.
The guader hardat gua canto.
not your brother.
You seek land, true enough. Land that is not yours nor any person's.
But only with your faith. There are those who would betray and manipulate you. Worse yet, take the land by force.
We are all too aware of the expeditions your people send against you.
What do you mean, my people? We are all one. We should act as such.
How? By signing our lands over to you? Then we'll be as one in your debt forever?
Sir William may have a point. What hope have we against their black powder and iron?
The spirits will guide us, as they always have.
Did they not guide us here?
Yes, that we might unmask the great betrayer.
This is a mistake. We should sign.
Peace! Peace! Have I not always been an advocate? Have I not always sought to protect you from harm? If you wish to protect us, then give us arms, muskets and horses that we might defend ourselves.
War is not the answer.
We remember, Stanwix. We remember you moved the borders. Even today your men dig up the land, showing no regard for those who live upon it. Your words are honeyed, but false. We are not here to negotiate, nor to sell. We are here to tell you and yours to leave these lands.
So be it. I offered you an olive branch, and you knocked it from my hand. Perhaps you'll respond better to the sword.
Are you threatening us?
Yes.
Ensured an end to your schemes. You sought to claim these lands for the Templars.
Aye, that we might protect them. Do you think that good King George lies awake at night, hoping that no harm comes to his native subjects? Or that the people of the city care one whit about them? Oh, sure. The colonists are happy to trade when they need food or shelter, or a bit of extra padding for their armies. But when the walls of the city constrict, when there's crops that need soil, when there's no more enemy to fight, we'll see how kind the people are then.
The colonists have no quarrel with the Iroquois.
Not yet, but they will. 'Tis the way of the world. In time, they'll turn. I could have stopped it. I could have saved you all.
You speak of salvation, but you were killing them.
Aye, because they would not listen. And so, it seems, neither will you.
Ayawas ne yate hagum sare am dahyayum ne skana ze zagum haja.
William Johnson is dead, and with him, the Templar plot to steal the land of my people. But in ending this threat, I have revealed another. On his body was a letter addressed to John Pitcairn containing orders to root out and destroy Patriot weapons and supplies. Should he succeed in this, the colonists will be unable to maintain their resistance, and the Templars will surely take control. So long as Pitcairn lives, the danger remains. I need to find him. He needs to die. I thought it might bring clarity or instill a sense of accomplishment, but all I feel is regret.
Hold fast to that. Such sacrifices must never come lightly.
I had to do it. Not only for my people, but for all the others Johnson would have harmed.
It's a start. But to truly be free of Templar influence, all of them must be dealt with in turn. Even your father.
I know.
You speak the words, but do you believe them? Seems we've company.
What is it?
A request for aid from Paul Revere. Seems the Redcoats are up to something in Boston. Guess you made an impression on the Sons of Liberty.
They mistake me for one of their own. Please tell Mr. Revere he has my sympathies, but I cannot help at present.
You might wish to reconsider. John Pitcairn is mentioned by name.
Where am I to go?
Mr. Revere's house in Boston. If you'd like, I can...
Ah, Connor! What a relief! You came! Allow me to introduce you to William Dawes and Robert Newman.
Your letter said John Pitcairn was here.
Aye. He's readying an assault on Lexington, where Adams and Hancock have taken shelter. After that, he will march on Concord, hoping to destroy our weapons and supplies. You must help us.
Only tell me where to find him, and I will put a stop to this.
He has dozens, if not hundreds, of soldiers at his command. Cannot hope to match him by yourself. But fear not, for you will not have to. We have an entire army of our own, merely awaiting the order to take up arms.
Then you must call upon them.
Indeed. You and I will cross the Charles River and rouse the boys. William, I need you to take the overland route and do the same. Robert, I need you up in Christchurch. Light the signal. Two lanterns, our enemy comes by sea.
No time for dawdling, my friend. We have lives to save. Come on.
They've only left a single horse. We'll have to ride together. Ah! You take the reins, I'll navigate. Quickly, Connor, get on the horse! I'll guide you towards those we need to alert. Follow my directions, and we'll be done in no time.
Go left up here.
I believe we are on course. I believe we are on course.
Redcoats. What are they doing here?
They must be scouts.
Be careful, Connor. We mustn't let them warn the others. To the right, Connor! To the right!
Might be safer if we approach the houses on foot. This is it! You have got the right place! Let everyone know that the regulars marched for Lexington and Concord!
The British are coming!
Back in the saddle, my friend! We have more people to warn! This way, Connor! I believe we are on course. This way, Connor! Excellent! We are right on course! Wouldn't surprise me if we ran into more trouble. Stay alert. Left! Connor! Be on the lookout for redcoats. We should dismount for this. Be quick. This is it! You have got the right place! Spread the word. The regulars are coming out.
At once!
Yes, this is exactly where we need to be. No, wrong place. We should dismount for this. It'll be quicker and quieter. This is it! You have got the right place! The regulars are coming.
Here! We're here! Get them!
Find a way to get rid of them, Connor! We need to lose them! If you insist on fighting them, Connor, ensure you win. That was much too close for comfort. Let us take care to avoid any further surprises. Is everything all right, my friend? Turn right! This way, Connor! Somehow. Yes, this is exactly where we need to be. Might be safer if we approach the houses on foot. This is it. You have got the right place. Devil, is he?
Are you sure we are in the right place?
Well, sure, I'm sure. Prescott?
Evening, gents.
Listen, the regulars are out. You need to rally your men. And, put on some trousers.
At once.
Welcome to Lexington, Connor. Now let's find Hancock and Adams. No sign of Dawes. I hope he's all right.
Paul, Connor, good to see you.
You need to leave. The Redcoats are coming.
Aye, so Williams told us. Let them conduct their little search. They'll find nothing.
You don't understand. Pitcairn intends to kill you.
I'm afraid it's true.
I suppose we have no choice then but to go. What of you three?
Dawes and I will continue on to Concord. Connor, it's best you stay here and help our man John Parker hold the town. It'll give us time to spread the word.